Hello students, in our previous session we have already explored the introduction of the chapter and about the author, and in our next session we went through some of the passages in our chapter and I had given you a line wise explanation of it. So today we'll go through page number 26 and first paragraph. I flailed at the surface of the water, swallowed and choked. I tried to bring my legs up, but they hung as dead weights, paralyzed and rigid. A great force was pulling me under. I screamed, but only the water heard me. I had started on the long journey back to the bottom of the pool. And as we have already discussed in our previous session, that one big bruiser boy, he came and he just tossed him into the water. And this author, he was just struggling in water, but he couldn't come upward. As he was having a strategy, like he will be coming to, when he'll touch the bottom of the pool, tiled bottom of the pool, then he'll just jump up like a spring or a cork and he'll be coming to the flailed surface of the pool. But he couldn't do so. So now he is here, he is just describing that I was feeling as if like a paralyzed and I couldn't like give up me a force, and just I was feeling as if somebody is pulling me under the water. I struck at the water as I went down, expending my strength as one of in a nightmare fights an irresistible force. I had lost all my breath, my lungs ached, my head throbbed, I was getting dizzy. Now he's saying as if like I was just stuck into water, I was just trying to spend my all strength, as if like some people used to do in their nightmare and just like try to gain that kind of force so that they would be able to survive. In the same manner I was trying to do, but I lost all my breath, and even if I was feeling like as if my lungs are aching and my head was just throbbed and I was feeling like a dizzy. Dizzy means like a just as if feeling like neutral, he couldn't do anything. But I remembered the strategy. I would spring from the bottom of the pool and come like a cork to the surface. I would lie flat on the water, strike out with my arms and thrash with my legs, then I would get to the edge of the pool and be safe. Now he is just discussing here as if like I just remembered my strategy, as if I was thinking that I would just like spring up to the bottom of the pool and just I'll be coming out of like it a cork, and I will be just finding myself on the flat, just lying flat on the water, and I'll strike my arms and thrash with my legs so that I would be able to come up to the edge of the pool safely. But he couldn't do so. So I went down endlessly. I opened my eyes, nothing but water with a yellow glow, dark water that one could not see through. Now he's saying I just went down endlessly and I was trying. I opened my eyes, nothing but just yellow thing of water, like only yellowish color of water I could find there, and it was just dark. I could not see even through that what is going on, as if I was finding myself helpless. And then sheer stark terror seized me, terror that knows no understanding, terror that knows no control, terror that no one can understand who has not experienced it. I was shrieking underwater. I was paralyzed under water, stiff, rigid with fear. Even the screams in my throat were frozen. Only my heart and the pounding in my head said I was still alive. Now, I was just thinking of as if this terror just seized me and I could not even have a control over me. And I was this only a person who have experienced in their real life, they could only understand. And I was just feeling as if like a paralyzed. And now, no more I could fight with this fear. I was just feeling like that. And I was screaming as if like I was just trying to scream, but nobody could hear, as if now I was feeling like my throat was also frozen. I couldn't scream more. And my heartbeat also started as if like stopping, but my head, I was feeling as if something hit very much hard. But yes, I found myself that I was yet alive. And then in the midst of the terror came a touch of reason. I must remember to jump when I hit the bottom. At last I felt the tiles under me. My toes reached out as if to grab them. I jumped with everything I had. Now, at last I found in that terror only just touch of that reason. Means as if he, like in previous session we went through, that he was thinking whenever he'll just touch the bottom of the pool, the tiled bottom, so he'll just try to jump over from there, and he reached to that bottom. So now he was just trying to jump over from there. He just remembered his strategy. So now he was just trying to jump up hard from there. But the jump made no difference. The water was still around me. I looked for ropes, ladders and water wings. Now he's saying, but that jump, that couldn't make any difference. I was feeling as if I was at the same place. No movement was there and water was still all around me. But now only a hope was there, that was like if I could find some ladder, water wings or rope. Nothing but water, a mass of yellow water held me. Stark terror took an even deeper hold on me, like a great charge of electricity. Now I was deep in terror, and even that was just as if feeling like a great charge of electricity around me, because that much shocked I was. I shook and trembled with fright. My arms wouldn't move. My legs wouldn't move. I tried to call for help, to call for mother. Nothing happened. Now I was trembling, I was shivering, but nothing could make. I was just that much frightened, and I was just trying to make a move, and even my arms, my legs couldn't move. And I tried to call for help. I was calling my mother, but nothing happened. And then, strangely, there was light. I was coming out of the awful yellow water. At least my eyes were. My nose was almost out too. Now, strangely, I was just feeling as if I could see some light, and awful that yellow water I could see. And I was just coming out as if I felt at that time. And almost my eyes, my nose were just out. I was feeling so. Then all effort ceased. I relaxed. Even my eye, legs felt limp, and a blackness swept over my brain. It wiped out fear. It wiped out terror. There was no more panic. It was quiet and peaceful. Nothing to be afraid of. This is nice. To be drowsy, to go to sleep. No need to jump. Too tired to jump. It's nice to be carried gently, to float along in space. Tender arms around me. Tender arms like mother's. Now I must go to sleep. Now he's saying, as if all effort ceased, I was just relaxing, and even my legs, like it just went on neutral, and something blackness as if swept over my brain, and almost all fear were just wiped off, and terror was wiped off. No panic, nothing, and it was that much quiet and like peaceful, the surroundings, the vicinity which I was finding during that particular time. So no more panic. I was not panicking at that time, but I was quite peaceful, and as if somebody is holding tenderly into their arm, as if I felt like my mother's arm. Now I must go to sleep, and now I felt that I must sleep. I crossed to oblivion, and the curtain of life fell, and I was feeling as if my curtain of life is fell, like I am almost dying. Now nobody could save me. I was just feeling that. The next I remember, I was lying on my stomach beside the pool vomiting. The chap that threw me in was saying, but I was only fooling. Someone said, the kid nearly died. Be all right now. Let's carry him to the locker room. Now next I am just remembering is that I was lying on the stomach and beside the pool, and I was just vomiting, and the boy who threw me was saying that I was just fooling, I was just playing a prank. But someone like beside me, he was just saying that the kid is but almost nearly died. What kind of prank, like he was just trying to do, as if someone is just trying to scold him, "Be all right now. Let's carry him to the locker room." "Oh, leave it. Now we must carry him to locker room." Several hours later, I walked home. I was weak and trembling. I shook and cried. Then I lay on my bed. I couldn't eat that night for days. A haunting fear was in my heart. Now, he's saying several hours. Like later, I just started to walking to my home. I was trembling with fear. And even for several days, like so many days, for several days, I couldn't even eat or sleep in night because that haunting fear just was coming into my heart every time. So the slightest exertion upset me, making me wobbly in the knees and sick to my stomach, like as if that much fear I was having. And I was having great like exertion of upset, just I was upsetting myself every time thinking this. But what could we do? Like whatever it is, that haunting fear was not just going out of my mind. I never went back to the pool. I feared water. I avoided it whenever I could. Now I never went back to pool, and I was that much feared, and every time I avoided whenever I could. Like I never used to go to that even side of the pool. A few years later, when I came to know the waters of the cascades, I wanted to get into them, and whenever I did, whether I was wading the Titan or bumping river or bathing in warm lake of the goat rocks, the terror that had seized me in the pool would come back. It would take possession of me completely. My legs would become paralyzed. Icy horror would grab my heart. Now, few years later, I came to know, as if I was very much fond of, I was very much fascinated of waters of cascades, and I wanted just go into it. But whenever I did, I was just wading and Titan or bumping river or bathing warm lake of the goat rocks. But this terror usually used to come in my mind and it used to seize me. So I never ever just tried to go back to that place. But I was very much fond of like these kind of activities, water related activities. But now I am having that much terror, that icy terror used to grab me every time, to grab my heart, and I could never ever go back to that place again, or to wherever, like to that water related activities, I couldn't go more, and I was that much feared. So this is all about today's session, and next we'll be doing in our next session. Thank you.